What's up guys, it's Tom here and welcome to the Liverpool-Southampton post-match analysis video. And I thought Liverpool played outstanding football in the first half. Didn't really create much in the second half, but I think the game was done and dusted. Liverpool were 3-0 up at halftime and Salah got another goal in the Premier League. I think he is the player that needed a goal for his confidence the most. And Southampton were just, defensively all over the place. In the first 20 minutes, they conceded two goals and a whole host of chances. And when you give away two very cheap goals, an own goal, and a free header to Matip, which he took very, very well. I thought Joao Matip played quite well. He made one misplaced pass, but otherwise he was really good. And I don't think Shaqiri came off because of an injury at halftime. Shaqiri, I think, came off because he's rested for the Chelsea game. So when you give two cheap goals away, if you are Southampton, you can't expect to get anything away at Liverpool. And Liverpool now extend their unbeaten run at Anfield to 18 matches. And the last time Liverpool conceded a goal at Anfield, Liverpool conceded a goal at home in the Premier League, is February 24th, which is incredible in my opinion. Our defense has been rock solid. And also our attack is always going to score goals. Today it wasn't Liverpool's best game of the season. We only had 12 shots, but in the second half, until the 75th minute there was no shot. No, wait, until the 85th minute in the second half there was no shot happening in the second half by both teams. The great news for Liverpool is that Manchester United dropped points again. They failed to beat Wolverhampton Wanderers, who played really, really well today at Old Trafford and scored an absolutely incredible goal by João Moutinho. You have to check that goal out. That is one of the goals of the season. So now Man United are 8 points behind Liverpool. This is what you get if you start with a 100% record after 6 games, and next week's game against Chelsea is absolutely vital and massive. Chelsea will most likely win tomorrow, but still, Liverpool can't do any more than this. We won the first 7 games of the season, and I can't remember when was the last time it happened. I think the record books are saying that Liverpool won their first 5 games in 1991-92 season. I don't know if they won the first 6 games of the season. And definitely in the past 100 years there was no instance where two teams have started off with 5 wins from 5. So imagine if Chelsea win tomorrow, there will be two teams with 6 wins from 6. I still feel that Manchester City is the team to beat. Man City have beaten Cardiff City 5-0 away from home with an absolutely dominant display again. Man City had 21 shots, Cardiff only had 2. So I think the major challengers for Liverpool will be Manchester City and probably Chelsea. Man United, Arsenal and Tottenham just look a little bit less consistent than these top 3 teams. And I really hope that Liverpool can hang in there with Manchester City week in, week out. But the next 2 games in the Premier League are, I think, season defining. Liverpool will play Chelsea in the League Cup. I think we will rotate the side quite heavily for that. But then Chelsea away and Manchester City at home in the Premier League, 2 absolutely critical games in the title race, and I think these 2 games will go a long way in showing how far Liverpool have actually come, because the biggest test so far has been Tottenham away and Paris Saint-Germain at home in the Champions League, and Liverpool came through those 2 games with flying colors. And we actually dominated both games. So if we could go to Chelsea and maybe get a victory there and beat Man City at home, then Liverpool's confidence will be sky high. But I think these 2 teams will be the teams that Liverpool will fight against in the title race. And I'm really looking forward to it. In other news, I felt Shadon Shaqiri put in a very, very good performance. He was in kind of a free role in midfield, and I felt that he always found a pocket of space between the Southampton defenders and midfielders, and I felt that he distributed the ball really well. And Shaqiri hits the bar with a ferocious free kick in first half stoppage time. I mean, imagine if that goes in. That was so unlucky from Shadon Shaqiri. The ball actually hits the bar, bounces just this much ahead of the line, and Mohamed Salah races, beats all the defenders with pace, and tucks it home from like a couple of inches out into the empty net. And that's how Salah got his first goal. He scored an offside goal in the second half, which was quite unlucky. It was offside, but Liverpool and Salah, I think Liverpool needed Salah to score today, because his confidence was a little bit low after that Paris Saint-Germain game, where Salah had a pretty mediocre game and he gave the ball away before Paris Saint-Germain scored. So I think Salah's confidence will be sky high. The big question is, who do Jurgen Klopp play in the Chelsea game? I think that we shouldn't risk the majority of the players who don't normally play in the Premier League. So I would start Nathan Clyne, I would start Matip, maybe Joe Gomez. Van Dijk went off injured, but it's just a bruise to his rib cage, so I don't think that Van Dijk will be out for any time. Maybe he will be rested for the Chelsea game, and maybe put Moreno in instead of Robertson, just to give Robertson a breather. He played every game so far this season. And also in midfield, I would select probably Fabinho, maybe Naby Keita, who didn't play against Paris Saint-Germain, and he got like 15 minutes against Southampton today. So I felt that Naby Keita is fresh, Fabinho is very fresh, so they could start, and maybe Milner, who only played one half. So that will be my midfield for the Chelsea game. And then I would start, you know, Shaqiri, Daniel Sturridge, and maybe Divock Origi or Dominic Solanke in attack against Chelsea. And that would be still a pretty strong team to play against Chelsea. But of course, it's at Stamford Bridge. Sorry, it's at Anfield, actually, the League Cup game. So I think that the Anfield crowd can help Liverpool, you know, actually beat Chelsea. And I think it's vital that Liverpool beat Chelsea in the League Cup, because that would kill a lot of momentum if we went out of the League Cup this early for the like second or third season in a row. And Chelsea have a very tricky game against West Ham, who finally got their first win away at Goodison Park, so they will be full of confidence. And I think it's going to be very, very interesting how the Premier League title race shapes up, because Chelsea play Southampton away and Manchester United at home after the Liverpool games. So I think that will be a very, very interesting two games for Chelsea. And also the Chelsea-Liverpool and the Liverpool-Man City games will show like who is right now maybe the best team out of these three. But of course, the most important thing is that the Premier League title race is a marathon, it's not a sprint. You have to be consistent throughout the whole season. But I don't even think that Manchester City will be as consistent as last season. We already saw that Manchester City can be beaten. They had a big loss in the Champions League against Olympique Lyon at home, with the majority of Manchester City stars playing. So I think that Manchester City are not unbeatable, and Liverpool is certainly their kryptonite. So I'm really hoping that Liverpool can beat Manchester City again at Anfield, because that would just give us such a huge confidence boost, and maybe it would knock Manchester City's confidence down. Overall, a very professional performance from Liverpool against Southampton. The first half, the game was over, it was 3-0. Second half, I would have liked a little bit more urgency from Liverpool, and Jurgen Klopp was, you know, telling the team to pass the ball quicker, to distribute it quicker, but Liverpool just took a little bit of a foot off the gas. And what is very, very encouraging is probably Liverpool didn't get out of third gear in these games. Maybe the best performance was Tottenham, the second best performance was Paris Saint-Germain. We actually put in the two best performances in the games where it was needed the most. And if Liverpool can win games while not playing so well, I think that bodes really well for the future, and I think this is the strongest Liverpool team that I have watched since I started supporting the club in 2001. And that is a lot. That is saying a lot. So let me know, what did you think of the game? What did you think of the Liverpool performance? Who was your man of the match? My man of the match was probably Mohamed Salah, who did quite well to score, and he could have scored even more goals. He got into all kinds of dangerous positions today. And Firmino was playing actually on the left, which was very interesting tactically, that Salah was playing through the middle, and he played really, really well there. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. See you later. Goodbye.